Again, I'm going with the aim shots. Maybe eyes, so if I can blind him, he might have trouble hitting me with this weapon. Yeah, he's dead. Yeah, two misses in a row, 90% chance to hit. I can't see. Yeah. More loot. Dogmeek doesn't seem to have any kind of armor, so I don't see how he can survive all this. Even with these guns, that aren't too dangerous, he took like 20 points of damage from a shot. Why? Oh, can I really fight Top Morbid? Go away. I'm not going to kill him. Mainly because I want to avoid trouble with the law. I'm not going to start a fight. But we took out his cronies and Buddha, so maybe he's gotten a warning. Maybe let's get scared. This is quite a dangerous business that he's involved in. The guards aren't hostile to us, so I guess there's no danger in killing those henchmen. So since we can't do the Skull's quest, we have Necropolis might have something for us still, but I'm not too interested in dealing with the ghouls. I'll tolerate them, but I'm not really a fan of them. I think the wasteland would be a better place without ghouls around. So become initiate, that means going to the glow. I don't want to go there with this kind of heavy load, because I want every piece of equipment I can carry from there with me. So I'll go to the better arms merchant in Hub and try to dump everything I can to get anything interesting. Maybe I can get even a should get some of those pulse grenades. If we'll encounter robots of Brass Knuckle, that isn't going to do it. Any idea where I could go? Gunrunners? Boneyard? They'll probably have something to suit your needs. I've heard the guy at the Brotherhood Steel packs some pretty powerful hardware too, so you might want to. Gunrunners? I think we'll maybe want to go there, actually. The problem isn't that this guy's selection is bad, it's very expensive, so it's bad for bartering, and it doesn't really have much or any unarmed combat benefits. So it isn't helping us in any way, really. How much is the combat armor? Yeah, 46,000. That's an insane price. The prices simply are terrible with him. I think grenades were like 500. Yeah, 1,000. This is at least double the amount we can get from normal merchants. So I think I'll go to the boneyard. This guy's, he's just got bad traits written all over him. And doesn't really have the weaponry types that I'm looking for, and I would like something new before I go to the glow. Maybe it's not a combat heavy place because it's radiated. So I don't know if that's a problem. Maybe the radiation is what I have to fight there. But I still would appreciate more anti-radiation trucks too. So maybe if the boneyard has a decent sized gun shop, it might have also sell medical supplies, and that means potentially anti-radiation drugs. I don't want to go there in the middle of the night. The shops will be closed. Yeah, this should be Addison, so it's one part of Boneyard. Welcome to Addison, stranger. Watch yourself, we'll be watching you. Can I ask a few questions? What do you want to know? I like some general knowledge about Boneyard. What part of town are there here? Okay, east of us are the followers. There are a bunch of peace nuts. East are the blade. A bunch of skags, if you ask me. Away south of us there's a cathedral where the children have their religious center. I'm not sure if that refers to the overland map or this place. I think the cathedral is at least on the over map south of us. How do I get inside? Sorry, but we have to be careful of strangers here. Too dangerous. Maybe you can do some work for Zimmerman. This okay. Who are you? Hello strangers, what can I do for you? My name's Ophelia. Pleasure to meet you, I'm Tyne. Okay, I think he's a merchant. What's your take, Addison? Ain't a bad little town. Zimmerman's a fair man, maybe not the brightest guy, and of course we've got Miles, probably the only man in 100 miles who knows anything about science. That sounds promising. Oh, yeah, but we already solved the water chip problem. Maybe we can talk to him about the mutants, though. So I think we have to talk to Miles. Let's see what he can actually tell us. Can I ask you about the half merchants? I do some trading with them from time to time. Mostly I sell bullets in exchange for food, so I'd like to do some trading. Ammunition. Ooh, plasma grenades. How much are they? Yeah, 200 for a bad plasma grenade. The hub, we had to pay like 1,000 for one explosive grenade. Definitely worth our time to come here. Plasma grenades are probably more powerful, and more importantly, they do plasma damage. Yeah, I'll sell a couple of these knives. Maybe some, maybe a knife. Yeah, and one. No, I'll sell actually another and take his money. Done. And I do want to see how much damage plasma grenade has. Okay, Molotov cocktail, 8 to 20, so not good, but it's still a thrown weapon and an explosive, so maybe we can affect multiple targets with it. 40 to 90, and it does plasma damage, which is we have much lower resistances usually against such damage. So very nice. I'm very happy with that purchase. Maybe we can find other good traders here, at least the gun runners. We already know about them. We just don't know where they are. Who's he? We're watching you. A regulator, I guess they're the local peacekeepers here.